You're listening to Pushing Underground Radio with DJ Awesome Wells. Hello and welcome along to another episode of Swing Brother Swing, my show featuring the best of jazz, swing, rock and roll, and oldies music. I've got a great show coming up for you today. To get you in the mood for some oldies culture, I'm going to play you a speech by Winston Churchill, and I think you're all going to know this one pretty well.
When Napoleon lay at Boulogne for a year with his flat bottom boats and his grand army, he was told by someone, "There are bitter weeds in England. There are certainly a great many more of them since the British expeditionary force returned. Sir, I have myself full confidence that if all do their duty, if nothing is neglected, and if the best arrangements are made, as they are being made, we shall prove ourselves once more able to defend our island home, to ride out the storm of war, and to outlive the menace of tyranny, if necessary for years, if necessary alone. At any rate, that is what we are going to try to do. That is the resolve of His Majesty's government, every man of them. That is the will of Parliament and the nation, the British Empire and the French Republic, linked together in their cause and in their need, will defend to the death their native soil, aiding each other like good comrades to the utmost of their strength. We shall go on to the end. We shall fight in France. We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender. And if, which I do not for a moment believe, this island or a large part of it were subjugated and starving, then our empire beyond the seas, armed and guarded by the British fleet, would carry on the struggle until, in God's good time, the new world, with all its power and might, steps forth to the rescue and the liberation of the old."
Stirring stuff there from Winston Churchill. That speech, of course, came at a time when it really looked like the United Kingdom was in a lot of trouble, and that really inspired a lot of people and really fired the nation up. So I've got a great show coming up for you today, including some music from Danny Kaye. Also be featuring some New Orleans jazz from regulars The Rebirth Brass Band, and also some John Boutte. And towards the end of the show, I'll be playing some rock and roll from Gene Vincent and Elvis Presley, amongst others. For now, though, let's hear from the Ink Spots. This is a lovely tune called Maybe.
Maybe think of me when you are all alone. Maybe the one who is waiting for you will prove untrue. Then what will I do? Maybe you'll sit inside wishing that I were near. Then maybe you'll ask me to come back again. And maybe I'll say,
Inkspots there with their song Maybe. I think that maybe is one of the deadliest words in the English language, really, because yes or no, you got a clear answer, but with maybe there's always hope, but there's always a much greater chance of disappointment. I never like to hear the word maybe. I like clear answers if I can get them. So I'm going to play you some music from one of the great band leaders now. This is Duke Ellington with his song Caravan. Duke Ellington there with Caravan. going to play you some Danny Kaye now. Danny Kaye was one of the most talented performers of all time, such a virtuoso in all fields. He was what is commonly referred to now nowadays as a triple threat. He could sing, act, and dance. This is a really fun little song called Tongue Twister. Do give some of these a go after you listen to the song, because it is a song all about tongue twisters, and you'll hear some in this song that you probably haven't heard before. But yeah, try and twist your tongue around some of these after the show and see if you can do them. So this is Danny Kaye with Tongue Twisters.
Everybody's heard of Peter Piper and the peck of pickled peppers that he picked. That's such a silly, simple children's game, it hasn't even got a name. But I'd like to bet that it'll trip you, like to bet you that you'll have to say you're licked. If Peter Piper you pronounce were these, then twist your tongue around these. Moses supposes his toes are roses, but Moses supposes erroneously. For Moses, he knows his toes ain't roses, that Moses supposes his toes to be.
That's Tongue Twister, and it seems so easy till a word gets sprung. If you insist you want to try a list, then step up, mister, and twist your tongue.
Now, Kissel will whistle at busty Miss Russell, who rustle and bustle till Kissel will roar. So Russell asked Axel for Kissel's dismissal, and this'll teach Kissel to whistle no more.
That's Tongue Twister, and seems so easy till you twist your tongue.
Tito and Toto were tattooed in Toto, but Toto was only tattooed on his toe. So Toto told Tito where Toto was tattooed, but Tito said Toto's tattoo wouldn't show. Theta thought Thora was thumping her thimble, but Thomas thought Thora was thumping a drum. Said Theta, if Thora's not thumping her thimble, I think that she surely is thumping her thumb.
It's Tongue Twister, and seems so easy till the word gets sprung. If you insist you want to try a list, then step up, mister, and twist your tongue.
Now, Charlie is cherry when choosing his cheeses, and cheese is a challenge when Charlie arrives. But Charlie is charming and chooses a cheddar, then chills it and chips it and chops in some chives. Hedda is hoping to hop to Tahiti to hack a hibiscus to hang on her hat. Now, Hedda has hundreds of hats in her hat rack, so how can her hop to Tahiti help that? Snobby Miss Nora is sniffing a snuff, but the snuff has no sniff and it makes Nora sneeze. When Snide Alice Norton hears Nora sneezing, she snappily snorts Nora sneezing a breeze. Sheila is selling her shop at the seashore, for shops at the seashore are so to lose. Now she's not so sure of what she should be selling. Should Sheila sell seashells or should she sell shoes?
Tongue Twister, and seems so easy till the word gets sprung. If you insist you want to try a list, then step up, mister, and twist.
Twister for Twistle was trying to whistle, but Twister for twisted his tongue.
Danny Kaye there with Tongue Twisters. I think you could put some modern MCs to shame with some of those rhymes. It's insane, isn't it? Oh, dear. I would have loved to have seen Danny Kaye live, but alas, I never would have stood the chance because he died in 1987, which is a year before I was born. So, yeah, shame about that. There's some great performances of him that you can dig up on YouTube. I thoroughly recommend it. And most of them good quality as well. Because he was in a lot of films and stuff as well, and a lot of these songs featured in films that he was in, Hans Christian Andersen being probably his most famous. I'm going to play you some nice smooth jazz now from the Blue Mitchell Quintet. This is a track called High Heel Sneakers.